Hey guys, this is Tim from Tim's Electronics Lab and welcome back to a new video in a sunny electronics lab. Alright, so we've got a few packages. They just arrived and I thought it would be a nice little video to make on some of the contents of this package. Well, there are two big ones. Not entirely sure what's in here. And then there's this one, and then there's this one. Now this is a local package. And it's the most interesting, I think. So I think we'll leave that for later. Let's start with this one. And this is a... pretty generic item. Just a little stock refill, because I run out of these things very quickly. Yes, these are the good ones. Now there are two versions of this available, as the camera got bombarded by the ESP. So as I said, there are two versions available. This one, this is the Node MCU V1. It contains the CP2102 UART2 USB converter, and then you've got this one which contains the CH340G as a serial to USB converter. Now you might already notice the difference. This one is a lot bigger and this one isn't. This one is not breadboard friendly. It doesn't fit on a single breadboard, it's too wide. And this one does, with one row on each side, I think. So this one is a lot better than this one, but this one was cheaper. So yeah, it's these are better. Please buy these and not this one. And they contain the CP 2102 serial to USB chip, which I found a little more robust sometimes, so this is also better. So moving on to the next package. Well, let's start with this one. It says Coplight, value of $15, which is about right actually. And this doesn't work. I'm surprised that they're written down on the package. Most of the times they don't. They just write a value down of 1 cent or a few pennies. So, yeah, the package sits very well, which is a good thing. Just do this way then, and it seems undamaged, which is also a rather nice addition to receiving packages. Well, when the packages come from China, you never know what you get and if you get it. And AliExpress has got, well, I would say very decent buyer protection things. So yeah, kudos for them. But this, as the package already suggested, is a Coplight. Yeah, so why do I need a Coplight? Well, for video recording. I thought it was time to create a little, well, a little, this is actually not quite a little. But I thought it was time to create a lightning setup that I can use to improve my video a little bit with. So, and it comes with an RF wireless, but is this, oh, there's no battery inside it, right? Oh, that sucks. CR2025. Take the battery out of my battery compartment. Is this the right one? 32. Oh, it's such an oddball battery thing again. Why? This doesn't sound right. Oh, it's the tray. But I guess if we cram it in there hard enough, it will work. Exactly. I think it is wireless, but this is just an LED that indicates activity. Yeah. Because I ordered it because it came with a 433 megahertz wireless receiver. Yeah, there you go, 433. Working voltage 12 to 24 volts. Okay, cool. So it works with an CR, what was it, CR2032? Yeah, these remotes work with a CR2032. Well, for starters, we just do 12. So let's do 12, make sure to connect it with the right polarity. So the current is, well, limited. Oh, so well, it's bright. It's very bright, but the remote doesn't work. Let's turn it off. The remote doesn't work. And why is that? Plus maybe the battery's, no, the battery's not flat, but the light wasn't very convincing. And then we get another battery. Maybe we need to set it up first. Not sure. Please pull out the insulate part, so the signal can pass through the barrier. It's on. Oh damn! I need my sunglasses for this. Let me put them on. Actually, this is very bright. I mean, so sunglasses on, it's still very bright, and the remote just crashed, I guess. Keep in mind that this is only at 12 volts, right? And it's drawing around 2 amps. That's 24 watts, which is, well, quite good actually. I'm starting to think more and more and more that this is not RF based. Doesn't seem to work, which is a shame. But yeah, I need it to work. AliExpress is definitely going to hear from me. Alright, so on to the next package, which also says cop light. So let's open this one up. I think I'll use the same method as the other ones. This is a weird looking cop light, you might ask yourself, and me of course. Well, that's true, but I guess they come from the same shop. I bought them at different AliExpress stores, but I guess they come from the same shop, because they're wrapped exactly the same. And if we open it up, oh, that's nice. You'll see that this is a heatsink, and they included pads for this thing, so we can place it onto the light, because this light is capable of delivering and using 200 watts, and it dissipates a lot of heat. So with this heatsink, it should be able to, and it fits perfectly. This is really nice. Now, let me check the, is this going to fit? No, let me grab my M3 screw box. Are these M3 threaded holes? Are they threaded at all? They look like they're threaded. They don't seem to... Oh, yes, there you go. M4. So they're threaded M4s, which is really nice. Only problem being that the heatsink itself is covering the whole cup light. So, but I might use this to attach a fan to it, because it might need some cooling. So it's a little bit darker, but I tried the cup light with a different power supply and it's still not working. So I'm going to do as suggested by the little manual. Remove the insulation. I can always add a new heat shrink around it. So that shouldn't be the problem. But maybe there's some kind of loose wire or something like that. Let's have a look. Now I did some research online, and this is a PCB with a microcontroller and a p-channel MOSFET, and there are mods that you can do to it to make it Arduino controllable, which I'm not going to do. The remote control part was the main decision for me getting this light, because if I get more lights, I think it's coming off. Ah, there you go. If I get more lights, then I'll be able to also to have them at the same brightness as each other with one remote control, not with two separate remote controls. So the circuitry looks fine, and I am thinking that the problem isn't inside this circuitry. Well, I think that this is the antenna. My camera focusing. Yeah, this is the antenna, I guess. So let's connect it to my lab bench power supply and try to dim it very close. Oh. To the actual antenna, and let's see what it does. I'm not expecting much, actually. Let's turn it on. No, not much. So I guess that it's the remote control then. Now there is a certain test that I still want to do with this LED, and that's basically a full brightness test. So let me turn off, well, not a full brightness, but well, maybe full brightness. So I'm holding it down at the moment with the heatsink attached to it. I'm hoping that I don't burn my hands or whatever. Because I'm planning on this being my new video. Oh. This is 6 amps. 6 amps at 16 volts. That's a lot of watts. That's around 90 watts, I believe. Oh, cool. Yeah, this is really cool. So we can bypass the LED controller, obviously. We'll see what happens here. Yeah, this is the limit of my LED bench power supply. And it's really bright. So let's do that again. Around 20 volts. It overloaded my LED bench. Oh, there you go. I thought for a second that either the LED or my power supply was dead. So let's turn it up again. This is 19 volts at, well, around 10 amps. So guys, this is 200 watts. And it was getting, well, rather hot. So that's a good sign. That's yeah, nice. So now I will actually use this light to light up the area in which I'm shooting my videos, so that you can see more. And I'm hoping that the camera gets a lot less grainy, because when I play back the footage, it's very grainy. So with enough light, I hope that this fixes the problem. Of course, I need to adjust my white balance, because it looked a little bit odd here and there on the camera. But I'm hoping that that this will do. So let's move on to the final package, which is this Dutch package, actually, not an AliExpress package. And I came across a website when searching for components for my lab bench repair videos that I'm doing. Let's remove this. And I thought, why not? Let's just order it. And I ordered a few parts. I, of course, ordered the parts needed for my lab bench power supply repair. And that are these two. Now, these are the ST version. And let's check. Yeah, they come from the same batch. These are the LM723CN power regulator control chips. And they're probably faulty inside the lab bench power supply. So I'll just replace them and check if the problem is fixed. Now, I also ordered LM317s. This is kind of like my backup plan. If the lab bench power supply in the end is still not working, I will convert it, make a nice project out of it. And for that, I needed the LM317 power regulator IC. So, and also I ordered an NE555 or a 555 timer, just for fun, just for giggles. Now I already had a few laying around. And finally, that's what I'm mostly amazed about. I ordered 9 meters. Is that correct? Let me check it again. Yes, 9 meters. Of black and red cabling. Now, why is that amazing me? Let's check loudspeaker HQ Power Professional. Yeah, this is loudspeaker cabling. Well, it doesn't really matter. All these items I paid €1 for per item. So the two 555 timers, 1 euro. The two LM723, 1 euro. The three LM317 was 1 euro. And per 3 meters of speaker cabling, it was 1 euro. So 3 euros for 3 meter or for 9 meters speaker cabling, that's a pretty good deal, I would say. So I'm not sure if they're having an outlet sale or something like that, but grab it whilst you can. Well, it's only for the Dutch viewers, unfortunately. But this is pretty interesting. So, yeah, I'll keep you updated on the COP LED. I'll create a nice video on how I created my own YouTube studio light. I'll make a nice little stand that I can use to actually put it like this and allow the COP LED to, well, actually light the area. I'll do some research on if a fan is needed, because the heatsink is pretty nice, but I'm not sure if the heatsink is completely able to cool it. But we will see. It seems like a pretty good, it's actually a perfect fit for this COP LED. They're not from the same store. Furthermore, the heatsink wasn't even listed. It was pretty hard to find. It was actually pretty hard to find this COP LED light as well. But yeah, it's really, really cool. So I hope you enjoyed this mailbag. I'll order a new remote control, I guess. Or I'll wait for the dispute to finish. And I see you guys in the next video. Hey guys, this is Tim. I hope you liked that video. If you want to see more, please make sure to subscribe. You can also share the video with your friends and hit that like button. I'll see you in the next one.